And we are back. We are live today at the Fathers Forum Myth Conference. And I have sitting at the table with me the beautiful Dr. Tuesday.
Bless your heart. Thank you.
How are you this morning?
I'm well. God is faithful.
All the time. So I am looking at your cute little table and your sign and everything. So I want you to tell everybody all that makes you.
Amen. Well, my main purpose of the earth is the ministry of the gospel, which is what we are here about today at the Father for Men's Conference. And so that's what I do. My ministry is T-Tate Ministry. And our purpose is to help people to activate and partner with people into their purpose through God's word or the teaching of God's word. So that's what we do in T-Tate Ministry. And then, you know, I was called into ministry almost 20 years ago. And I was in corporate doing the show, my honey, making my six figures, traveling all over. And God called me up out of there. And I'm like, that's the devil. That is not God.
What about you, Lita?
I'm Lita, kind of money. And, you know, right? And so literally overnight, I went from, you know, making that type of money to walking away. And God did that, and then just over time, what my standing joke is, what we realize is that sometimes in ministry you get a check, and sometimes you get a chicken dinner. And so I had to, like, okay, God, I got to live. So he just allowed me to kind of reach into my bailiwick of skills and talents and used what I was doing in corporate training and coaching and things like that to start my organization, my company called Vision Focus Group, and where we help you bring your vision into focus. And so we do that with corporations, with not so much individuals. I don't do a lot of individual coaching, but I do a lot of relationship coaching and executive coaching and training through Vision Focus. And then, as I was coming into my 50s, I started saying, well, I'm 50. I will be 51 today. I am in my 50s. So, I forgot, man. So, as I was coming into that, I had just had this passion that I've had for probably 20 years to start a coaching company and a speaker's firm.
Okay.
So God allowed me to do that, and I launched into that. And so it's the title of my company. Is ATK Speakers and Publishing Firm.
Okay.
ATK stands for Advance the Kingdom. And so we will, if you're a non-believer, you're not a Christian, we will still publish your book, but your book has to be motivating, encouraging.
Absolutely.
That at the end of it, somebody leaves with a purpose.
I love that.
They leave being encouraged. So so that's what I do. I'm an aunt, I'm a daughter, I'm a, yeah.
All of the above.
Yeah.
So what inspired you to come to the men's conference today?
Well, excellent. What inspired me is that it's the vision God gave me.
Okay.
So it's his plan, but his vision. I started the Father Loss Forum in 2011. Where I would bring men together in one setting and women in another setting to talk about fatherhood. And then, so for the last, you know, so we're in the year 7, but the last one I did was in 2016. And one of my speakers was Pastor Michael Jones, and the men would share, and Brother Robert Mays has been to them. So several of the pastors have done them, Pastor Hampton, Pastor Preston, Pastor James Jackson, Pastor Eric Whitaker, A. Thomas Hill. So several of them would just come and share their stories, community leaders, regular men, Richard Samuel, with purpose and a story. And so they would come and share. And in 2015, God told me to do the conference. And I was like, and being a woman and things like that. So I resisted it. And Pastor Michael Jones encouraged me, let's do it. So he was going to come alongside of me to do it, you know. And so fortunately he passed away July 2016. So I didn't do the forum, I didn't do anything as related to this. So as we came into 2018, God was like, you're going to do this conference, little girl.
Okay.
Because you're not listening.
You're being disobedient. Don't let the whale eat you up while you try to run in that direction, right? So I did kind of run in that direction because in 2016 I had my first women's conference, which I knew I was supposed to do. But in 2015, he told me to do the men's conference. You feel me?
Exactly.
So, I didn't get eaten up by the whale because I went in another direction because I was still fulfilling purpose. But when we came into this year, it was let's do it.
Okay.
So I have these wonderful volunteers of women that I support and several pastors in the community. Well, I would say every pastor I spoke with encouraged me. They did. This is great. This is what we need. Because churches do things for their men, but there isn't what I had not seen, and I would say in years, if at all, was a citywide, statewide, and we're going to declare one day countrywide,
yes, ma'am,
men's conference to meet the needs of men, just men.
Yes.
All the men are in there, all the women are out here, and we're here to just serve and make sure they get what they need.
I love it.
But it's all about the men, and it's not just about men with father issues, right? Because this is what I say. If you came from the seat of a man, you need to be at this conference.
How about that?
Because that means you have a father.
Yes.
Right? You might not have a daddy.
A lot of people don't understand the difference.
There is a difference.
There's a difference.
Because God himself is Father and Abba, Daddy.
Yes.
And the father role of even God and our earthly fathers is to provide, protect, instruct, and discipline.
Yes.
That's what God does as our father. But as our daddy tells us, we're great, we're awesome, we can do anything, all things are possible. You know, this is what daddy does. A safe daddy, you can sit on his lap and it's safe, right?
Absolutely.
And he loves you. And even though he still has to discipline you and correct you as your father, he'll still say, but our parents would say, you know, I'm doing this because I love you.
Because I love you.
Well, why you gotta hit so hard? But anyway, and why I gotta get how many licks? Great God.
How much
one will do. Just one good stern lick, right? But you know, so yeah, how much do you love me?
Yeah. Is it just over love?
Yeah, I'm not feeling it. So that's what daddy, the role of a daddy.
Yes.
And so all of us have a father because we came here by the sea.
Absolutely.
But all of us do not have a dad.
That is so true.
And so the father forum seeks to help men to just if you can, one, forgive him.
Mm-hmm.
You know, most of our fathers, they didn't come into this. They didn't know.
They didn't know.
They didn't know. They don't have what fathers have today. And even with everything that men have today as fathers, they still have struggles because they didn't see an example. And men learn by example. They learn by what they see. And short of God showing them a different way or them aligning themselves with another man, saying, yeah, I like how he's doing it. And prayerfully he's doing it right. Let's do this, right? So it looks at all parts of the man as the husband, the father, the mentor, the leader, you know. So looking at all aspects of that man and helping to build him up to be the prophet, priest, and king that God created. So that's what the Father Forum Conference is about.
Well, amen. I'm glad you're being obedient and listening to Jesus.
Me too. I try.
It's tried.
Yeah, teach me to obey, even when it hurts. Yeah, even when it hurts, teach me to obey.
So are you going to make this an annual event?
You know, we're going to see what the Lord says. Fathers and family came alongside of me, and this is the Father Forum presented by Opportunity Indy, which is an extension of Indiana Black Expo. So they are our presenting sponsor. And so I'm hopeful that when they send back the report and they see what God did, it will be something that can be ended.
Yes.
One of the things I thought, this don't mean this is how it's going to happen, I have to seek the Lord, but I thought, okay, I'll do men, then the next year I'll do the women, the next year men. But men have already said, oh yeah, next year do this. You
so
know,
they're preparing already.
I'll prepare my schedule. But amen. Brother Bay.
Well, and that could have been God speaking for somebody else.
Absolutely, absolutely. So I'm open. I'm open to whatever people say. I always jokingly say that Bishop Jakes is my spiritual father. He doesn't know it.
I understand. Mm-hmm. I have a couple of
But we're going to meet. We'll meet. And I'm declaring I'm going to be on that stage one day.
Yes, ma'am.
Amen. And so just ministering the word. So the But with that, he does an amazing conference called the Men Power. And that's in Dallas.
Okay, yes.
And everyone can't get to Dallas.
I don't know.
And so for those who can't get to Dallas, let the Father Forum Men's Conference be in the Midwest, what you can get to. And then still go to Men Power if you desire. But there are men with power right here in Indianapolis.
Yes, ma'am.
And our keynote speaker today, Pastor Marvin Millsap, is one of the Manpower speakers. So Manpower has come to Indianapolis through Pastor Marvin, Bishop Marvin Millsap. And so he will be here this afternoon. And we're doing something a little different. He's going to actually just sit down and talk to the men.
Versus actually writing a speech and preaching to them.
You know, I would say I would pray he just comes up out of his belly. The man can preach. Mm-hmm. People don't, I mean, he can sing,
absolutely,
but he can go. I'm like a man when it comes to preaching. I'd be on the edge of my seat. Like, girl, you a lady, cross your legs. I'd be like, oh, Jesus, that was good. Preach, Jesus. So, glory God. So, what we're doing is what is going to be called Men Talk with Dr. Martin.
Okay.
And so the men have a form that they can check what topic they want a question about. It could be being a single man, it could be a widow, it could be how do I help my wife to forgive me, it could be being a single pastor, being a pastor. So all of these questions that men may have. So they can write out their question and then the moderator will just pull that question and ask him and he'll go. But it also will allow the men in the audience to share their father stories as well, or talk about whatever they need to talk about. Because we wanted to not only have the conference setting where we have the workshop,
yes, sir,
but we wanted to have the forum setting where men can talk. And that's where I see the breakthrough happening. That's where I see men getting their healing and getting their answer.
Yes.
It's when men are able to talk. Y'all saw them out here.
Mm-hmm.
We like go in the sanctuary. Go in the sanctuary so we can start. And they out here mingling and talking because that's what men do.
Exactly.
When they come together. But they often, they often aren't allowed. I won't say allowed, but they often don't just have the time.
To actually
do it, because they trying to make it happen, right?
All the time.
And so we have great workshops for them. Jamal, let's talk about the morning. We have Pastor Tyler Hill is talking about millennial manhood. What does that look like?
Because
manhood for my dad, who would have been 82, even for Brother Robert Mays, who's standing here, and other men, it doesn't look like that for our millennials. So what does that look like? So they're going to hear from millennials.
Okay.
On what that looks like. And Pastor Tyler Hill and Pastor Jeffrey A. Johnson Jr., the second, will be doing that workshop. And one will do the first session in the a.m. and the next will be in the second session in the a.m.
Okay.
And then there's a workshop on prayer for men, the power of prayer, praying man. Pastor Daryl Brooks will be doing that. Then there's also a workshop on Whitney Hamilton and Malcolm Taylor will be doing a workshop for teens. The blessing today is that Whitney's dad, in his coming up, was addicted to drugs. But he's clean now. And he's here with his son today. Glory to God. And he's here with his son today, and they're both going to share their testimony of healing when the men all come together for the men.
That's awesome.
Isn't that awesome?
That is awesome.
And so, and Malcolm's story is that from his mother's womb, his father was in prison. And he came back like 3 or 4 years ago. Now he's trying to build this relationship. So how do I do that? And so, they're breaking.
They're moving.
Let's make sure our men know where they need to be. Beautiful ladies.
I love Hallelujah. It, guys. She's directed from the mic.
I'm sorry.
Multitasking.
We gotta, you know, it's what we do. I need them to come out with some woo woo or something so I know they heard something. Do a bark. Aren't you? What are you?
Capper.
Neither?
He said nine. They're poor.
Okay, no, his dad. I thought you were enough.
And that here.
Okay. Well, they're getting ready to go into their breakouts. Hallelujah.
Yeah, so just so you guys know, because I mean, she's literally directing from the mic, which is fine, because I understand as women, we are great multitaskers. But the guys are coming out now, and they're going into their breakout sessions. Some strong black gentlemen walking out this door.
That is amazing. You know what? That's fine. That's fine.
of you?
They just were like, oh, I quit my job, and then now I'm great.
Yeah,
no, something happened in the middle, and I'm in the middle.
A lot of crying, a lot of praying, a lot of fasting. Real talk.
All of that. So I'm going to let you be free.
All right.
Thank you all for tuning in.
Thank you all. Thank you for tuning in.
Bless you. Thank you all for tuning in to JQ, yo. Be great, yo.
If you want to keep recording...
Thank you all so much. Bye. We'll see you in the afternoon.